Hello guys and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this tutorial, I'll be teaching you how to create a simple AI image analyzer web app using the Streamlit package. If you are new to my YouTube channel, kindly subscribe so you don't get to miss any of my future tutorial. You can also put me on post notification so that when I drop any new tutorial, you instantly get notified. Enough with my self-promotion stuff, so let's get right into it. Alrighty, so first we'll look at the prerequisites we need for this particular tutorial. The first thing first, you will need to get OpenAI API key. Specifically, we need GPT-4o API key. So you have to sign up with OpenAI and get your API key. So that's the first thing we need. Alright, with that out of the way, the next thing you will need is probably some images laying around. So I have three images here which we'll use to test our final product. From there, the next thing is the libraries we'll be using. So we'll be using the OpenAI library. We'll also be using python.env to load our API keys. Finally, we'll be needing Streamlit, which we are going to use to create our user interface. So that's all we need, and this is pretty much it, only three libraries, okay? So you have to install this library. I've put in all of them in requirement.txt. So once you clone this particular repo, all you need to do is to write pip install hyphen r requirement.txt. And when you hit enter, this is going to install all these packages for you. I have already installed these packages, so I expect my requirements to be already satisfied. Alright, so if you have done this, this is a great job done. The next thing is that we need to create the Python file. Okay, so I'll create a new file, and over here simply I'll call it main.py and hit enter on this. Alright, so that's another step completed, and from here I'll go ahead and import the libraries we've installed. So I'll do import Streamlit. So we'll do import Streamlit as st. From here we also import OS, so just write import OS. We'll go ahead and also import load.env from .env. So you have to type from .env we are going to import. Alright, so from importing .env we have some couple of imports more. So we have to import base64. So import base64, and base64 will help us to convert our image into base64 format. And that's the format our OpenAI client accepts. So that's why we are importing base64. Then finally, from OpenAI, we are coming to import OpenAI. All right, so these are all the imports we need. And I think that's pretty much it. If we need any extra, we'll come back and import it as needed. Alright, so from here we have to set up our API keys and also set up our model we'll be using. So in order to grab all this API key, I'll just type load.env and that's it. So this will go ahead and load all API keys stored in .env files in our particular directory we are working in. And from there we can just get our key. So I'll say key is equal to os.getenv. And that's because we've imported OS. And in here, I have to type the name I've given to the API key. So I've given it OpenAI underscore API key. So this is the name I have given to my API key. So you have to type that exact name you have given to the API key in your .env file. Okay, so from here we also instantiate the model we want to use. So normally I like to write this in cap. So I'll say model is equal to the particular OpenAI model I want to use. So I want to use the GPT-4o. So I'll just type that and that's it. So this is a particular model I'll be using. So this is O and not zero, GPT-4o. Alright, so that's it. We've just set up everything that we need. Okay, from here you have to also set up your client, okay, and this the client will be using to analyze our image. So I'll just type client, and this client is equal to OpenAI, and inside OpenAI here you have to give it your API key so that OpenAI can authenticate you and allow you access to their model. So I'll just write API underscore key, And this is equal to our key we've instantiated here. So I think that's all for setting up whatever we need. All right, the next step from here, let me just hide this so that you guys can see everything clearly. I'll hide the terminal as well. The next step from here is to write a function that will convert our input image into base64 format. And that's very simple. So we write def, which stands from defining the function in Python, and we'll call it encode underscore image. So this function will encode images as the names says, and this is going to take an image. Okay, so we just give this function an image, and that's it. So from here, this function will just return any image it takes in base64 format. So this is equal to base64.base64 encode. Okay, so base64.base64 encode, and that's what is going to encode your image for you. So whatever image we have given it, we are going to do the image.read. Okay, image.read.decode, and the decoding format you are going to use UTF-8. Okay, so UTF-8, and that's it. All right, so this all this function is going to be doing for us. This function will just take an image and encode the image, okay, using the base64 format. All right, so from here we are very good to go. We are good to go. We can continue and now design our Streamlit interface. Okay, so we'll start by giving it a title, and we have imported Streamlit as st right at the top here. So all we need to do is to write st.title, and over here we give it a title we want. Okay, so we are doing image analysis, so we just have to write maybe image analyzer. You can write anything you want, but I think our image analyzer will be just a fancy good name to use. Is the spelling correct, or let me write it this way? So image analyzer, and that will be our title for this particular web app. Okay, so from there we have to design an image input. Okay, so inputs for our image where users can upload image. So we can say call this image, and this is equal to st.fileupload. Okay, all right, so st.fileuploader, and inside here we just have to prompt our users to tell them upload an image file, and that's it. So there are some couple of things we can also specify, which is the type of image you'll be accepting. I think for security reasons you can put this out there, but if you don't mind you can just leave it. I'm just going to do it. So you can write type, and this is equal to list of some of the images you'll be accepting. So in my case, I'll be accepting PNG, I'll be accepting JPG and JPEG as well. So you can just list all the images, type of images you'll be accepting. It's all up to you. So I'll just list these three now. You can add more, you can add WebP and so on. So these are the images I'll be accepting, the image extensions I'll be accepting. And from here, I have to check if there is an image uploaded so that I can continue to work with it. So for that, we'll just use a conditional statement, if statement. So I'll just do if there is an image, as if image, or if there is an image uploaded, I'll go ahead and work with this image. The first thing I'll do is to display this image. Okay, so I'll do st.image, and in here I have to display the image. So the name is image, and I think we have to change this name so that we don't have any conflict. So I'll call this image file instead. All right, so this should be image underscore file, and then we can display image file. All right, so we display the image file if there is an image uploaded, and we can give it a caption. So these things are just something you would like to add. So the caption, I'll just give it maybe is equal to uploaded image. And from there, in order not to make this image take the whole space or take the whole screen, you can also specify this particular parameter, use underscore column width, and you've set this to true. By default is false, so this will just take some small portion, and your image will not take the entire screen. So this is kind of handy. And that's it. So we check if there is an image, we display the image, and now from here we have to convert that image to base64 format. So we've defined our function, and this function is called encode, and this will return our base64 image. So I'll write base64 image underscore image is equal to the name of our function, which is encode image, and inside here we give it our image file. That's it. So this will receive our image file and encode it and return to us the base64 format. Alright, so now everything is set and done. We've put in our image in the right shape, and from here we have to just pass this image to the model together with our prompt for it to work on it for us. So from here I'll just call this response, and this is the response the model will return to us, and this response is equal to our client.chatCompletion.create. Okay, so client.chatCompletion.create. I think for this I'll just have to copy so that I explain it. It's kind of something from OpenAI, so I'll just copy it and paste it right here. I'll just paste this as I said, and that's it. So let me just format it well. This should be here, and then so okay, that's it. So response is equal to client.chatCompletion.create. So this is where we are coming to give our prompt and also passing our base64 image. All right, so inside here the first thing you need to specify is the model. So model is equal to the model we have defined, and over here the name we have given is our model, so you just have to put the particular model name you have defined. So I'll just put it here, and this is our model. From here we also have message, and this is where you put in your prompt. So message, you have the row as the system, and over here you put your content. So the simple content I'm giving you are a helpful assistant that responds in Markdown. I just want a Markdown of everything, and over here I'll just press Alt Z to format this nicely. Okay, and here what you are trying to tell this client to do is to describe the image and create a report, highlight important details, and provide recommendations. Okay, so this particular client is going to do all of this. Anything you describe here, that's what this client is going to do. But at the end of the day, you have to pass in your image. Okay, so we have given it the URL to this image, and this is our base64 image. You can also specify the temperature, and this temperature value shows how creative your model will be. So you can play with it. It's a hyperparameter. You can play with it and you'll see different results. Okay, so from here, this will return to us our results, and we can just have to write it down or put it down. So this response variable will store in our result, and from there I just have to print that result. So I'll do st.markdown, and inside here I'm going to mark down our response. Okay, so this will be response.choices. I don't know if I spelled that correctly. At the first index dot message dot content. Alright, so this how to extract the particular response from your client. Okay, so you take it response.choices at the first index.message.content. Okay, so if everything is alright, now I can save this and we can give this a try. So to give it a try, I'll just first bring up my terminal, and now we are ready to run. So for Streamlit, in order to run a Streamlit app, you have to write Streamlit run and the name of your Python file. So in our case, the name of our file is main.py, and I'll just click enter here. So let's see if this works. Everything should work great. All right, so our app is running, and automatically Streamlit will open your browser for you in order for you to see what you have done. You can also check the terminal to see if there are some errors, but I think in this case there is no error, and we can continue to view our app. All right, so we got our title image analyzer, and over here we are to upload some image. So first let's upload an image and see what we'll get. So I open my desktop, and we are working in this particular folder. And I'll upload the third image to start with. So let's see. Okay, first we display the image. And now let's see what is going to generate about this image. Let's wait for the report. Okay, report on family garden activity. So it tells you a family with their garden. And the observation, the image depicts a family of four in a garden. The family consists of two adults and two children. The garden is lush with various plants, including leafy greens. So this is fantastic. We just clicks, you put in an image, and this particular model is able to give you whatever important details is in this particular image. And you can read this out for yourself. This is great. This is a very awesome feedback from this particular model. And for you to get your desired result, you can always play with this particular prompt, okay? So the prompt is your power. Whatever you want, make sure you write a prompt to give you exactly that, okay? So you are not limited as to getting the same feedback. If you want another type of feedback, you have to just play with this prompt, and this is going to generate that for you. But in our case, I think this is looking awesome. So I'll go ahead and upload the next image, and let's see how it works with this one as well. So the second image is also an image of people in the farm, but it's kind of very blurred. So let's see how it works with this, and let's see. I'm waiting for whatever is going to report on this. So report on agriculture field image. Yes, so it is. It's an agriculture field. And observation, the image depicts group of people working in agriculture field. That's true. The field is lush with green plants, indicating healthy crop growth. Workers are engaged. Yeah. So the important details, number of workers. Approximately 6 individuals are visible in the image. Let me check. There are more than 6 individuals, but that's what it can see. 3. I think this is 6 and 9. So the model can see about 9, but it said 6 are visible. Okay. Weather condition, the sky is clear, suggesting favorable weather, field condition, and so on. Guys, so this works, and this is how you can build a simple app to do image analysis for you. Finally, let me try with the final image we have here. And this is, let's say, some damage going on here, and you can see. So let's see what it says about this particular image. Report on observe scene. So observation, building condition, the image depicts a heavily damaged multi-story building. Okay, so you can also see a helicopter. Okay, so important details, structure damage, military equipment, safety concerns, recommendation, evacuation and safety. So that's it. So it's working nicely based on the prompt I've given it, and you guys can tweak this prompt to get any results you want at all. So that's it for this tutorial. Let me know in the comment section if you guys want us to host this app with Streamlit Cloud so that everybody can get access and use it. Let me know in the comment section. And if you have watched up until now, thank you so much for watching, and also make sure you share with one or two people. Thanks for watching once again, guys. I'll put this code on my GitHub repository, and also make sure you give me a star on GitHub. And up until then, I'll see you in the next tutorial.